morning, everybody. Welcome back to Soundlink TV. We're right here at the Vans Warped Tour, the last one here in Charlotte. This time with the Story Untold. How are you guys doing?
Pretty good.
Good.
I'm good.
Everybody's doing good.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's a lot sunny right now, so like I guess that's better than what it was doing earlier with the rain and all that.
Yeah, it was like raining like crazy.
Oh yeah, it was right when we were playing, so I'm just happy that people decided to stay and gave us a chance to play music under the rain.
Okay, nice. How was that playing in the rain?
I was good. I mean, it wasn't the worst that we did. I think the worst was in Texas. Yeah, it was just like they had to shut down the site and reopen it. So that was way worse than it was today. But it's awesome. I mean, I think people go harder when it rains. So
yeah.
It's always a good time.
All right, now you guys are new to Warped Tour and everything, and you guys have a new album out this year.
Yep.
And so as a younger band, you know, knowing that you guys got the opportunity to play Warped Tour, but
yep.
Never again will you get to play Warped Tour. Like, what were those emotions like?
I think it was just like mixed for everyone. I think we're just like very, very stoked to be on the last one. We didn't think we were gonna get it because the day we learned about the fact that we're gonna be on Warped Tour was the day after that our manager told us that this was gonna be the last one and that we didn't really have any chances to be on it. So I think we're just like all very surprised and we're just very grateful and thankful that we get to experience what's Warped Tour. And
yes, big thank you to Kevin Lyman for putting us on the bill. That's Janik said, we're really grateful.
So. Yeah, no, it's just been amazing. It's very exhausting, but amazing.
Okay, so what has it meant to you guys growing up, you know, watching it from afar and everything like that? You know, did you ever think you'd get to play this?
I think this has always been like the goal, but being from where we're from, like in Montreal, they wouldn't come like every year. So I don't think we experienced it as much as like the people in the US, but it's always been like one of the main goals for the band. So yeah, it's just amazing that we get to be on it.
Okay, now being a younger band on the tour, you know, pulling your own and stuff, how has the crowd been for you guys, you know? With this record being out and you guys being a younger band,
really, really good. We were surprised to see the response because we were expecting less, actually.
Yeah,
so
way
it's
less.
Been like exceeding our expectations. So yeah, we were really stoked about it.
Yeah, to be honest, we came here with the idea of playing in front of like 20 people every day, but there's been like over hundreds, like pretty much like every time we play, unless we're playing at the same time as Simple Plan.
Yeah, and maybe same time 1,000.
Yeah, sometimes even 1,000. Just been amazing. And
maybe most of the time 1,000.
Yeah, no, it's so. And even like the meet and greet, I would think that there would have been like, you know, 10 people in line, but we're just like taking photos for hours, and it's just amazing to see that. I'm very thankful that people are coming to the merch table and just like decide to take their time instead of like going watch other bands. It's just amazing, and I'm just very happy.
Yeah, and that builds later on for like, you know, the later tours, you know.
Yeah, yeah,
like
no,
the fall into the next year and stuff, those same people will be coming back, you know.
Yeah,
it's crazy because during our set we always ask the question like, is it your first time seeing us?
Yeah.
And who's haven't seen us before, and like we could see like that most of the
there's
crowd
a lot of
haven't
people
seen us before.
Yeah.
Like there's way more people that haven't seen us live before than people who have seen us live, so it's just a very good way to put our music out there and to gain new fans. And
okay,
yeah, it's awesome. Yeah.
Now, you guys are one of our favorite up-and-coming bands at our publication and stuff.
Awesome.
The record's phenomenal and everything.
That's
and it's
amazing.
Because
thank
you guys,
so much.
You guys don't sound like every other, you know, like pop-punk band, if you want to call it that, alternative band. So you guys have, like, you know, different styles and influences going into it. So where do you guys pull influences from, and what went into this record you guys dropped?
Actually, that was the whole point, I think, of the album, to separate ourselves
from these
other bands. And, you know, we really wanted to find our sound and go in a more of a alternative direction, you know, music-wise. But, yeah.
I think we're still, like, learning. I mean, with this album, the main idea wasn't to create something completely different, but to create something that already exists, but, like, better, if I can say that, like, 2018 version. So I just think we went through, like, our like, you know, childhood inspiration, like, Sum 41. But also we decided to take, like, a touch of like the modern music that's coming out, like Bring Me the Horizon, Paris, and bands like that, and try to create like a blend of all of that together. So that was pretty much like the main idea for the album. But we don't know what's gonna happen for the next one, and then the next one, and all that stuff. But.
All right, so what's happening for you guys next after Warped Tour? Anything you talk about for the fall? Or a lot of people have been saying they can't talk about stuff.
Yeah,
so.
We can't talk about stuff, but I definitely think that we're going to have some more tours. I cannot say like anything yet, like you said, everyone's saying. But also, I think we're going to try to catch up on some sleep. because we don't get the chance to sleep very well.
Yeah. Are you guys in a van or are you guys in
a
van?
We're in a van. Oh, I think we're like the only band that's in an 8-passenger van that's been on the whole thing, if I'm not mistaken.
Wow,
but,
okay.
Yeah, we're like, funny fact, we have like this smallest vehicle. It's crazy. Like,
yeah, you hear people talk about their buses breaking down, which sucks, you know, because you got to get somewhere. But you guys are trucking in a little van and it's still like coming along.
We didn't have many issues with the van so far, so we're just like very, very thankful. I'm not touched. Just like that's what.
We're going to see like some tweets going out tonight saying your van wouldn't start. We jinxed it.
I don't want that to happen.
All right. But, yeah. So, you know, just seeing all these bands in a van and buses, you guys in a van, you know, I guess that's got to be a little, you know, does it do anything mentally or whatever?
I think it's just the fact that
luxury is just like a few feet away from you.
Yeah, well, the thing is that we cannot reconnect with them because they're like, I'm tired and stuff like that. I'm just like, hey, we had to drive like all the way from this place to the next one like ourselves. You guys have a driver and you guys got to have bunks and shit. Yeah. But
I'm not complaining or anything, but like it's really fucking hard. The fans and the reaction we get makes it all worth it. You know, like it's crazy. Like, our fan make it seem like a piece of cake, you know, all of that. So it's crazy to see, like, it's just really motivating, you know, to keep on going and stuff. So
all right guys, well, thanks for talking to us today and everything. Looking forward to seeing what you guys have planned for the rest of the year.
Thank you so much.
No problem. I'm Trent with Soundlink TV, hanging out with Story Untold. Thanks for watching. Thank
you. So are you in or out? 'Cause I don't know what you're thinking about when you ask me to stay.